Hello friends, this video on human health and diseases part 13 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. So let us now try to understand acquired immunity in little more detail. So acquired immunity is creation of a memory of a disease causing organism, for example virus or bacteria. So the concept behind acquired immunity is something like this. Let us suppose this is your house. I'll take the same example of house security guards and the thief, where house is your body, security guards are the immune system, and the thief is the disease-causing organism. Now what happens is, now let us consider this scenario. Let us suppose a thief attacks the house for the first time. Okay, so the thief is really powerful and he attacks the house for the first time, and there was just one security guard to protect your house. Now when the thief attacked for the first time, it was realized that the security guard was not strong enough to protect the house from the thief. So what happened as a result of this, the attack became successful. The attack was successful. Now what happened? Now with this experience, there were more security guards which were employed for the protection of the house. So now the security became stronger. Now when the security became stronger, now what happens? Let us suppose the same thief comes back. Now if the same thief comes back, now the security guards already know the power of the thief. So they will recognize, now if instead of this thief, let us suppose a gang of robbers come. Now in that case, again we don't know whether the security guards will be able to protect the house from the gang of robbers or not, because they are not aware of the power of the robbers. But if the same thief comes back, the security guards will be able to protect the house this time, because they are already aware of the power of this thief. So as soon as the thief will try to approach the house, the security guards will be able to protect the house and the attack will become a failure. Now, based on this similar concept, the acquired immunity works. So here what happened? It was all because the first time when the thief attacked, the security guard, the one security guard which was present there, he remembered the thief. He restored the thief in his memory. So the next time when the thief came again, he recollected if this is the same thief or not. So when he found that yes, this is the same thief, what happened? They were able to protect the house from the thief, and the thief had to run away. So that means it is based on memory. So in acquired immunity also, a memory of the disease causing organism is created inside the body. So there are certain cells inside the body which can remember that pathogen. So if the same pathogen attacks again, then what will happen? The body will fight against that pathogen with a greater force, and as a result, the pathogen will not be able to win, and as a result, the body will be protected from the infection. So that is the concept of acquired immunity. Now, this response which the body gives in response to the attack is called primary response and secondary response. Like when the thief came for the first time, then the response which was given by the body, that is called primary response. And when the same thief comes back again, that time the response given by the body is called secondary response. So in this case, primary response was given by one security guard. Secondary response was given by this multiple strong team of security guards. So these are called primary and secondary responses by the immune system. Now, I hope the concept is clear. This is the basic concept of how acquired immunity works. Now we will talk about the primary and secondary response in terms of the immune system. So what is primary response? It is a low intensity response because the pathogen here is encountered for the first time. Now here I would like to give you an example so that you can relate it to real life. For example, you would have heard people getting vaccinated for certain diseases. So what is that vaccination? Now what happens in vaccination is, there is one type of vaccination where a small dose of the disease causing organism, that is a small dose of the pathogen, is introduced into the body. Now when a small, very small dose of pathogen is introduced into the body, it is so small, the dose is so small that it will actually not cause a major disease. But when a small pathogen is entering inside the body, what will happen? The body will recognize it as a thief, But this time there is just one thief, and the thief has come for the first time. So the body's immune system will give a low intensity response. Now, even though the body gives a low intensity response and the body doesn't get impacted in any way, because anyways the thief was it was a very weak thief who is not capable of fighting much. So similarly, the pathogen is very weak, so the body will not have any adverse effects. But what happens if the same pathogen actually attacks? Because that was vaccination. So let us say the vaccination was given for smallpox. Now the pathogen which causes smallpox, when vaccination was given, that pathogen came in a very mild dose. So it came in very small amount. So, but the body remembered that pathogen. So it will store that pathogen in the memory. So when the same pathogen attacks the body again, now the body is prepared to give back a good response. So here, when the same thief comes back later, this was the first time and this was the second time. And the second time it comes back, the body's immune system will give a high intensity response. Now when the body gives a high intensity response, the pathogen will not be able to cause the disease. So the pathogen will be thrown out of the body. So this is the secondary response. The secondary response is stronger, and secondary response actually helps to get rid of the disease. That is why you would have often heard that some people say that sometimes if somebody has suffered from chickenpox, even though when that person was 5 years old or 6 years old, the probability that he will suffer from chickenpox once again is very less, because already he has suffered it once. So the body has already recognized the pathogen which caused chickenpox. Similarly, when somebody is vaccinated, vaccination is nothing but introducing a very, very mild dose of that pathogen. So the body recognizes that pathogen. So body has already given a primary response once. Now when the second time attack happens, their intensity or the response is going to be a very high intensity response. So this is how acquired immunity works. So memory of the first encounter is always stored, and this plays the most important role in acquired immunity. Now the question is, how are responses carried out by the body? So how is this primary response or the secondary response given by the body? So what is present in the body? What are those cells which create these responses? Now, lymphocytes help in producing immune responses in the body. So now we have to spend some time understanding lymphocytes. What are lymphocytes? Now, there are two types of lymphocytes, that is B lymphocytes and T lymphocytes. These two types of lymphocytes perform two different functions, which coordinate with each other to provide responses, that is primary and secondary response by the body. So let us see what are B lymphocytes. Now often B lymphocytes and T lymphocytes are also referred to as B cells and T cells. Now the first thing that might have come to your mind is, what does B and T stand for? Why do we call them B lymphocytes and T lymphocytes? So let's have a look. In the B lymphocytes, the term B stands for bursa of Fabricius. So this is an organ which is present in birds, and this is the organ where the B cells mature, where these kind of lymphocytes mature. So after the name of this bursa of Fabricius, it has been abbreviated as B lymphocytes. Now many people think that here B stands for bone marrow, which is not the case. Now in all vertebrates, now this organ is present exclusively in birds, but in all vertebrates the B cells are produced in the bone marrow. However, you can remember it like this, that B for bursa of Fabricius, B for bone marrow as well. So in all vertebrates like human beings, these type of cells are produced in the bone marrow. Now what about the T lymphocytes? T lymphocytes, T stands for thymus. Because thymus is a gland which is present in the vertebrates, and this is the site where these cells mature. So basically the site where these cells, the lymphocytes, are produced, that is called, they are called B, that portion is the bone marrow, and the site where they mature, that is the thymus. So they are produced in bone marrow and they mature in thymus. So these B lymphocytes and T lymphocytes, they together perform the job of giving immune responses. So let us see, what do B lymphocytes do? So B lymphocytes produce antibodies in response to pathogens. So whenever pathogens are encountered, whenever the body encounters a pathogen, so there are protein-like structures called antibodies. So antibodies are nothing but protein structures. So these antibodies are produced by the body. And what are antibodies? So we will talk about that also in little more detail. So this is how the structure of an antibody molecule looks like. And what are T lymphocytes? So T lymphocytes do not produce any antibodies, but they help the B lymphocytes to produce antibodies. So basically, this antibodies actually, antibodies are nothing but which protect us from the pathogens. And these antibodies are the immune responses which we are talking about. So the B lymphocytes will produce antibodies and T lymphocytes will help B lymphocytes to produce antibodies. So we can see that lymphocytes are those cells which play the most important role in the immune system of human beings. Thank you. Please visit examfear.com for an easy 4-step learning process absolutely free of cost. Watch video lessons, ask questions, refer notes, and take an online test. Thank you once again.